in places where I think Democratic policies are needed, where they are helping, where they are making a difference, but where people feel as if they're not being heard, and where Democrats are characterized as coastal, liberal, latte-sipping, you know, politically correct, out-of-touch folks. We have to be in those communities. And I've seen that when we are in those communities, it makes a difference. That's how I became president.
That's the second time, John, since the election,
but
that
he has gone on an extended tangent that is so clearly an indictment of Hillary's campaign. Right. I mean, he doesn't say it directly there, but that's, of course, what he's getting at. Right. And by the way, I saw Tim Kaine, I think last week it was, and talked to him, and he said something very similar to me, which was, in Virginia, in my state, you know, what we do in our campaigns there, unlike this past campaign, is even the counties that we know we're going to lose, we go there. Why? To the margins. Because losing a county 60-40 is a lot different than losing their 80-20.
But, or to show respect for people you're going to have to govern, even if they vote against you.
And Obama did that.
But the question is, does the party take its advice? Because let's be honest. And the president was actually quite candid about it. He won two Electoral College landslides running for president. He was unable to transfer his popularity in any of the elections, whether it's the midterm elections of 2010 or 2014, where the Democrats got spanked and the Republicans made huge gains, not only in Congress, but at the state level. And then, obviously, he campaigned aggressively for Secretary Clinton. And there's no evidence. I mean, it's not his fault, but there's no, he wasn't able to automatically say, hey, you know, African-Americans, turn out. Hey, Latinos, turn out in the same numbers you did in 2012. Young people, turn out in the same numbers you did in 2012. So will they listen to him now?
They're caught in this tug of war because, on the one hand, you do have demographics that are moving in almost permanent favor toward Democrats if Republicans can't make gains with Hispanics in particular. So they're looking at these numbers that are pointing in one direction, and yet at the same time, it is true that Hillary Clinton did not show up in places where she should have showed up. So that is the, you see it playing out in the DNC fight right now. I think that Obama would probably, in his heart of hearts, argue for the demographics because he is a numbers guy, a data-driven guy. But he also, in 2008, was in Indiana and won that state, and he did it because he showed up. So, again, it's the push and pull right now.
But the truth is, the policies he's pursued have not been aimed at the people he's talking about there. They have been aimed at those sort of coastal liberals or the rising electorate. I was out in Wisconsin a couple weekends ago, and there was a conference at the University of Wisconsin, and there was a Q&A involved with one of the professors there, whose name is Catherine Kramer, who's done a wonderful book called The Politics of Resentment. She spent years literally going around Wisconsin talking to people. Somebody in the audience got up and said, what is it that Democrats can say to people in these rural areas? And she said, you know, I think the first thing is Democrats have to listen to people. Not just showing up and giving a message. It's understanding what it is that drives those people who voted overwhelmingly for Donald Trump.
And then speak in a way as you explain your policies that they relate to. That's part of Hillary Clinton's issue, was relate, but people didn't feel like they related to her. Speaking of Hillary Clinton, she spoke to donors this past week, and we're circling back a little bit to the whole Russia hack, but in a different, more political context. She spoke to donors the past week, and she said, yes, Putin did this, and he did it because he doesn't like me.
We're also learning more every day about the unprecedented Russian plot to swing this election. And this is something every American should be worried about. Vladimir Putin himself directed the covert cyber attacks against our electoral system, against our democracy, apparently because he has a personal beef against me.
Now, the more they learn about this, some Democrats say, Mr. President, you had this intelligence. Mr. President, you knew this at least in September. Why weren't you more open about this? Why didn't you try to help Hillary Clinton if this was happening? The president at his press conference saying, not my job.
I wanted to make sure that everybody understood we were playing this thing straight, that we weren't trying to advantage one side or another, but what we were trying to do is let people know that this had taken place. Imagine if we had done the opposite. It would have become immediately just one more political scrum.
It was interesting there because the president was saying they did issue a statement in September, the intelligence agency, saying this had happened. It was pretty straightforward. It's happening. We believe the Russians are responsible. We believe it goes high up in the Russian government. It didn't say we think they're trying to tip the thumb for Hillary Clinton. And the president didn't talk about it. You know, he didn't add it to his campaign speeches. Hey, Russia's messing with our elections or something like that. The president also defended the FBI.
Yeah.
And James Comey, the FBI director, this just a day or two after John Podesta, the Clinton campaign chairman, wrote a vicious, harshly worded op-ed in Dan's Newspaper Post saying there's something wrong at the FBI and it needs to be cleaned up. If you're a partisan Clinton Democrat, you probably didn't like what you heard from the president there.
And you're seeing some of those frustrations from the Clinton supporters starting to be aired in public right now. And it's fascinating to think of a split between the Obama and Clinton factions. Again, there was no good answer for Obama in this situation. He's right. If he had weighed in more aggressively against Comey and had pushed the intelligence agencies to make a determination about why the Russians were doing this, he would have just been torn apart. And it could have had the effect of energizing Trump supporters even more. So I think he probably made the right decision as president. But again, if you're a Clinton supporter as a Democrat, it's huge frustrations right
and
now.
And I also think to the point of, you know, mentioning the Podesta op-ed, look, there were federal investigators who tried to warn the DNC, senior officials at the DNC, repeatedly that there were hacking attempts. And they did not heed those warnings or take any steps to do anything about it and improve their security until months later. So there is culpability on multiple fronts on this point. But I think, you know, the overall, we are past the election. Donald Trump is going to be president. And I think that, you know, nobody's trying to push back on that at this point. But Russia is still attempting to hack U.S. political institutions. This is not a problem that is going away. And we now have a president-elect who is not acknowledging that. And two, who made a habit of questioning whether the election was rigged and is now has evidence that, you know, whether they were doing it because it was a personal beef against Hillary Clinton. U.S. intelligence seems to think it's more likely they want to send our elections into chaos or at least make people think that they are chaotic as an attempt to undermine our democracy. That's a serious problem. Like, it's surprising to not see a president-elect talking about this. It's surprising to not see an even louder chorus of Republicans talking about it.
Well, they will, I think once we get into January, once we're through the transition, we're in a new administration, especially a certain group of Republicans are going to be vocal. We'll see if the new president comes along with them. A footnote before we go to break, just want to show you a picture. We have had three